Hello and welcome to Walk the Talk. I'm Shekhar Gupta. In a part of Purana Kila of Delhi, one of the oldest seats of national political power in India, also something built by one of the great governors of India, Emperor Akbar. And my guest today is somebody who lives in the neighborhood and now RTI Commissioner, Satyananda Mishra. Welcome to Walk the Talk.
My pleasure.
You know, sir, at a time when everybody is becoming a self-styled warrior against corruption and discovering, trying to find new and new weapons to find it, yes. You actually preside over, or you control, or you have in your armory the strongest weapon,
yeah. RTI. You are absolutely right, because this is one law which has touched the minds and hearts of people all over the country. I mean, from the number of applications requesting for information that you get all across the country, it is now exceeding 3 million in a year. So that only shows that how many people are getting information about what is going on in the government. And nothing could be a better weapon to fight corruption and opacity in the government than getting information about what is going on.
But as a former bureaucrat, you don't see the merit, you don't see merit in what many of your colleagues say, that this has now become a nuisance.
Yeah, I think that if you are in the government, then you will look it at as a nuisance, because you will have to ferret out the information, then you have to provide it. Sometimes it might be somewhat embarrassing. But for someone who is retired and now, whether I am with the commission or not, for a retired person who is not in the government, you then realize that how important it is to have this kind of a law. Otherwise, you would, even if I have been in government for 36 years, I may not be able to get any information on my own.
Right. So, unless you had a batchmate.
That's right. So therefore, it's very important.
But do you think people have learned to use it?
Not yet.
Quite a lot of people have learned to use it. But, you know, just like the people in the RTI movement and in the commission, so we feel that more and more people should use it. But I think that we should not be, you know, disappointed at the pace of its progress. In just 5.5 years, no other law would have really spurred the kind of you know, enthusiasm.
It's caught people's imagination.
Absolutely. I mean, now something like 3 million people seeking information across the country.
But this has also caught the bad guys' attention, because so many RTI activists are being attacked.
That's true. Because, you know, an RTI activist is, in common perception, is anyone who just is seeking information. Many people seek information for private and personal use. Only those people who consistently seek information about public good should be identified and recognized by society as RTI activists. And I think that in the districts, the district magistrate, the superintendent of police of any district who are responsible for law and order and protecting private citizens should know who are the RTI activists.
Right.
So I don't see why this is happening, because any good district magistrate or any good superintendent of police would after a month in the district would know who are the RTI activists.
That's
and
the-
then provide the necessary cover to them.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Faster scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.